हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू अवर ऑनलाइन क्लासेस। इन प्रीवियस सेशन वी हैव स्टार्टेड वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन बैंक, सो वी हैव डन विथ चैप्टर 1 एंड चैप्टर 3। टुडे वील टेक ऑन चैप्टर 2 क्वेश्चन बैंक। The title of chapter 2 is Consumer Behavior. As you know students, consumer is a very important in economic activities. Out of all 5 elements, consumption, production, distribution, exchange and public finance. So out of all these 5 elements, consumption is the first or the inception element in economic activities. So consumption, to study this consumption or consumer behavior, we have all discussed the budget set, budget line, law of diminishing marginal utility, law of demand, types of demand distinction, and elasticity of demand. So after all knowing these concepts, from exam point of view, question bank is very important. So we'll see consumer behavior question bank. So as we discussed, the first section, A section, is consisting of 20 marks and it is divided into 4 parts. The first part is choose the correct answer. The first question is utility. 4 options are given in front of you. Utility, as you know, it is a want satisfying power of commodity or a service. So utility, here in this question 4 options are given. First one is objective, second one is subjective, third, that is C option, is both A and B, and D option is none of them. Now as you know, the features of utility, it is a psychological entity and it differs from person to person, place to place and time to time. So utility is subjective. The correct option or the appropriate option is B. Utility is a subjective concept. Next, the shape of an indifference curve is a normally, so 4 options in front of you, convex to the origin, concave to the origin, horizontal or vertical. So indifference curve is a ordinal approach given by Allen and Hicks, where they are trying to measure the utility not in terms of numbers but in terms of preference or ranks. So the correct or the appropriate option here is convex to the origin, A option. The shape of an indifference curve is always convex to the origin. Next, third one, the consumption bundles that are available to the consumer depend on, the consumption bundles that are available to the consumer depend on, the first option is color and shape, second price and income, third income and quality, and last one is none of the above. Here again it depends upon the consumer budget and the price of the commodity. So the correct or the appropriate option is option B, price and income. So always consumer first see the price of the commodity and the ability to pay for this, that is the budget or income of the consumer. It decides what commodities he is going to produce or purchase, sorry. Next, fourth one, the equation of budget line is, so again there are 4 options in front of you. The appropriate option is option C, where price of X1 commodity plus price of X2 commodity is always equal to M. M stands to money income. where when you plot this on the diagram, you'll find the downward sloping straight line, which shows that the given income and the price of two commodities is always equal to the money income. Next, fifth one, the demand for these goods increases as income increases. Normally, what happens if the income increases, the demand for the normal goods, that is durable goods or normal goods, will increase, but whereas inferior goods will decrease. So out of these four options, the fifth answer or the appropriate option here is normal goods. As the income of the consumer increases, the demand for normal goods also increases. Next, sixth one, the vertical demand curve is, so out of five elasticity of demand, types of elasticity of demand, so which one is the vertical shape? The vertical demand curve indicates perfectly inelastic, shows perfectly inelastic. If it is horizontal, it is perfectly elastic. And third one is unitary elastic, then relative elastic, relative inelastic. You have studied all those types, but vertical demand curve means whatever may be the change in the price, the demand will not change. It is not having any impact on the demand. So the demand curve shape will be vertical straight line, which indicates perfectly inelastic. Seventh, ordinal utility analysis expresses utility in, just now I told you indifference curve is a ordinal, it is a concept given by two economists, Allen and Hicks, where they have tried to measure this utility in terms of numbers, not in terms of numbers but in terms of rank or consumer preferences or grade. So ordinal utility analysis expresses utility in terms of, not in terms of numbers, returns or awards, it is in terms of ranks. I hope, students, you got all the answers with brief explanations. So these are your correct options for 7. Choose the correct answer part. Next part in this section A is fill in the blanks. Now the first one is, want satisfying capacity of a commodity is utility. And two indifference curves, never, you might be studied in the previous session, properties of indifference curve. So indifference curve or two indifference curve never intersect each other. If it intersects, it is going against the law of indifference curve analysis. So it never intersect. Third one, as income increases, the demand curve for normal goods shifts towards rightwards. Just now we discussed rightwards means increase. As the income of consumer increases, the demand for normal goods will increase. But when we are showing in the form of diagram or demand curve, we'll show that increase means rightward shift. Then obviously it decrease means leftward shift. Have to remember this, increase means rightward shift in demand curve, decrease means leftward shift in demand curve. Fourth one, the demand for a good moves in the dash direction of its price. As you know, law of demand, if price falls, demand increases. If price increases, demand rises. If price increases, demand falls. If price falls, demand increases. If price increases, demand falls. So the demand for a good moves in the opposite direction. Always they move in a opposite direction. Next, method of adding two individual demand curve is called. It is also called market demand, or mathematically it is horizontal summation. The two individual demand curves, at the same price, two individuals will be demanding different quantities. And if you add both the different quantities, you will get one value, and that values are called as market demand, or it is a horizontal summation. Moving to the next part, match the following. demand curve, as I discussed, when there is opposite relation between two variables, when we plot on the diagram, we will get a downward sloping line. So the correct option for demand curve is option B, downward sloping. Then linear demand curve. Linear demand curve indicates the demand is a function of price A minus BP. So when we calculate this, we'll come to know exactly what this equation is. So as the price changes, it is having the impact on the demand. So the linear demand curve option is A. Next, unitary elasticity of demand. So where we just now discussed five types of unitary elasticity of demand. So one type of elasticity of demand is unitary. It is uniform. If the price is changing by 5%, the demand will also change by 5%. So both move in a same proportion. So the correct option here is ED is equal to 1. 1 means both move in a same direction. Whatever the change in price, percentage change in price, is having the same impact on the percentage change in demand. So it is called unitary elasticity of demand. And mathematically it is written as ED is equal to 1. Fourth one, complementary goods. Complementary goods are the goods where both the commodities are interdependent. They are not substitutes. Substitutes are where you can have alternatives or the choice. If not A commodity, we can consume B commodity. If not X, Y commodity. But in complementary goods, both are interdependent. Pen and ink, car and petrol, car and bike. Yes. Many examples where both goods are interdependent. Tea powder and sugar. These are all complementary goods. Then fifth one, indifference map. As you know, if there is only one indifference curve in the diagram, it shows the combination of two goods giving the same level of satisfaction. If there are more than one or two or three indifference curves or four indifference curves, they are called as a family of indifference curve. Or indifference map is nothing but a family of indifference curve. It is the set of all indifference curves is called as indifference map, where each indifference curve is showing the different levels or higher level of satisfaction level to the consumers. This is your match the following. Coming to the fourth part, that is answer the following questions in sentence or word. First one, what is budget line? Budget line is nothing but a graphical representation of all possible combinations of two goods which can be purchased with given income and given prices is called budget line. So point to be noted here, given income and the prevailing prices that come out is called budget line. When we plot this on diagram, we'll get the budget line, which indicates the possible combinations of two goods which can be purchased. Next, what do you mean by cardinal utility analysis? We have discussed ordinal, now this is cardinal. Here, it is anything we are measuring utility in a cardinal numbers such as 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. is called cardinal utility approach. If you are measuring in terms of numbers, not in terms of numbers, if you are measuring in terms of rank preferences, it is called as ordinal. When we are measuring in terms of numbers, it is cardinal utility analysis. Your law of diminishing marginal utility is the cardinal utility analysis given by Professor Alfred Marshall. Next, give the meaning of third question, give the meaning of marginal utility. The utility derived from the consumption of an additional unit of a commodity is called marginal utility analysis. What is this? It is the additional consumption of additional unit and additional utility derived is called as marginal utility analysis. Next, what is utility? As you know, Want satisfying power of a commodity or service is called utility. It may be commodity or it may be services. So anything which is satisfying the human wants or the things which is having capacity to satisfy human wants is called as utility. Next, expand MRS. The rate at which one commodity is exchanged for the another commodity is called as marginal rate of substitution. MRS full form is nothing but marginal rate of substitution. Next, what do you mean by indifference curve? The graphical representation of various alternative combinations of goods which provide the same level of satisfaction to the consumer is called indifference curve. As I told you, there are different combinations of two goods, but any combination if the consumer is choosing, lying on the same indifference curve, which will give him same level of satisfaction. So it is called indifference. Indifference is nothing but no difference for him. Any combinations lying on the same indifference curve gives the same level of satisfaction. Next, what do you mean by the next one is, what is demand? A very important concept in economics, that is, what is demand? In ordinary language, demand means desire or want or wish. But in economics, it's not mere desire. Here, demand is nothing but desire plus ability to pay plus willingness to buy. If it is backed up by ability to pay and willingness to buy, if the desire is backed up by ability to pay and willingness to buy, then it is called as demand. In other words, the quantity of a good that a consumer purchases in a market at a particular price at a particular time is called demand. I hope, students, you understood this all four parts of section A, which carries 20 marks. I request you to practice these answers, because this question bank is very important. We'll continue the second part, section B, C, D, and E in the next session.